Hi everybody, this is Crystal. So are you guys ready to learn some cable stitches today? Don't go, because I'm going to show you how easy cable stitches are by showing you how to make this beautiful, beautiful crochet poncho. So welcome to my channel, Back a Day Crochet, where we talk about everything that is yarn and crochet related. So if you like that type of thing, please do not forget to hit that subscribe button. I got thousands of tutorials and lots of yarn content I think that you will enjoy. So we're going to be doing this poncho today. Now you saw that picture of that is me wearing the poncho. Now I am 5'3", so you can adjust the length on your poncho to as long as you want. Ponchos are very versatile as far as size goes. To make it bigger, you just add more rows, which will in turn make it wider and longer at the same time, or you can make it smaller by leaving off rows. So that is what I suggest as far as sizing goes. And this is what it looks like. The cable is very, very easy to do. As long as you know the basic stitches, you're gonna be able to do this. It's only a 3-row repeat. You got this. You can do it. Even if you've never made a cable before, you're going to make this, and I'm going to show you how. It's going to be super easy. Cables can intimidate some people, but don't let them. Don't let them win, because once you get them down, you realize, why was I intimidated at all? All right, I'm just going to give you a quick size on mine so you can kind of get maybe a little comparison. I'm going to do it at the very point of the neckline, the part that goes in the most, you know. So from that all the way down to the bottom, mine measures 30 inches, or about 76 centimeters. And then I'm going to go from the widest point of the arm to the widest point of the other arm, and it measures about 35 inches, or about 90 or 91 centimeters. All right, so that just gives you kind of a gist on the size. So let me go ahead and move this and take it out of the way, and we'll talk about the yarn that I use for mine. All right, move my camera here. So for this particular poncho here, I used Yarnspirations, which makes Caron, the Colorama Halo. They're perfect phasing yarn. Love this yarn. It's a beautiful, beautiful yarn. Let's see what we can say about this yarn here. Okay, so it is classified as a bulky number 5. Now, is that a good classification? I think that's fine. I think that you can use a 4-weight yarn as well. So any 4-weight or 5-weight, as long as it's a thinner 5-weight, will work just fine for this project. So if you have 4-weight, that's going to work just fine. And if you have a bulky, they classify this as a bulky 5. If you have a thin one like this, that will work as well. And it's 71 acrylic, 18 nylon, and 11 polyester. There's 481 yards or 440 meters. Now, for the size that I just showed you, and you know, you've seen it on me, I told you how tall I was. I used 2 complete balls and probably 150 yards of another ball. So 2 complete cakes at 481 yards, and then probably 150 yards of another. That's for my size. Now, if you make it bigger, you know you're gonna need more yarn than that. But it was, you know, I had to buy 3 balls to make this poncho, but this is what I have left of my third one. So still probably used to, you know. And then the color that I used, I did not use this color, but the color I use is called Amber Ocean, of course, but you can use any color that you want, and you don't even have to use this yarn. This yarn is kind of a fuzzy yarn, but it's very nice. It's a soft fuzzy yarn. But any 4-weight or any thin bulky 5 will work just fine for this poncho. And it's not a heavy poncho either. I know it looks heavy, but it's really not heavy. But it is made for the fall and winter time. All right, and then you're gonna need a size K, which is a 6.5 millimeter crochet hook. All right, let's do this. All right, so we're gonna be starting off with the neckline. And you want to start off with a chain of 76 stitches. We're going to be making a big ring and then slip stitching it to make the neck opening. Now, I highly, highly recommend do not adjust the neck opening, even if it seems small, because it will stretch with the weight of the poncho, especially with these cables. So I highly recommend that you stick with the 78 stitches. So just go ahead and chain until you get 78 chains on your hook. All right, so once you get your chain of 78, I am showing you with a different color, so it's easier to see. That fuzzy yarn is sometimes hard to see. So you just want to follow your chain down without twisting it. Now, you don't want to twist it. Just keep the front side of your chain facing you at all times. And then you want to slip stitch into the first stitch. Just like that. And then we're going to chain one. Now that chain one does not count as a stitch. We're going to go back into that same spot that we just slip stitched into, and we're going to work a double crochet. So right through there, and then double crochet. Now for row one here, we are going to go around our chain here without twisting it, and we're going to work one double crochet in every stitch of the chain. Just like this. You can just take your time to make sure your chain doesn't twist. It's fine. And I'm going to continue around putting one double crochet in every stitch until I make it to the end of row one. All right, so I've made it to the end of round one, and you should have 78 stitches, the same number as our chain. So we're going to go ahead and end by slip stitching into our first double crochet here. Just like that. Now we're just going to just pull up a little bit so you don't lose your loop. And we're going to mark off our, this is a two-point poncho, so we're going to mark off our point. It's just a little bit easier to do that. All right, so our first point is going to go right here into where we just slip stitched. So if you want to put a marker there, that's fine. We're going to have one there. And now what we're going to do is we're going to count 38 stitches. We're not going to count this stitch here, our very first one that we just put a marker in. We're going to start with the next one, and we're going to count 38. Right here. Now in the 39th stitch, we will put a stitch marker. So that would be the front point of our poncho. So that's the 39th stitch. Now we're going to count again on the other side to make sure we have the correct number. We don't count this one that our stitch marker's in. Go ahead and count the stitches to our first stitch marker and hope we should have 38. I have. All right, we are good to go then. So we got our 2 points marked off, and our first one's going to go right here where we just slip stitched. All right, so we're going to chain one. I'm going to go ahead and take that stitch marker out because I know where it's going to go now. And we're going to go back into this very first stitch, and we're going to work two double crochets into that spot. Only two. So there's one, and there's two. And now I'm going to put a double crochet in the next two stitches. So one double into the next, and one double into the next. And now we're going to start the repeat of row, excuse me, of round two, and we're going to be starting it with a cable. So this particular cable that I'm doing for this poncho is worked over four stitches. So we're going to yarn over like we're going to do a triple crochet. So we're going to yarn over twice, and we're going to skip two stitches. Skip, skip, And we're going to work a front post triple crochet into the next. So you skip your two, skip, skip, and then the next. Go around the post of that stitch like that. If it's easy, I always crimp my work like this in half so I get a firmer grip on it. And then yarn over and pull it through. And then go ahead and do a triple crochet as you normally would do. Like that. And now we're going to go to the next stitch and we're going to do the same thing, a front post triple crochet. So yarn over twice, go around the post of that stitch like that. I'm going to hold my work real still and do your triple crochet like you normally would. Now, for the cable, we do have to do a cross part of the cable. Now, this is the cross part, which means we have to back up and work into the two stitches that we skipped, starting with the first one here. So we're going to do the same thing. We're going to yarn over twice. We're going to do a front post triple crochet into the first stitch that we skipped. So just go right back around and around the post of that first stitch that we skipped and do a front post triple crochet like that. And then we have to go into the next one that we skipped, and cables kind of get a little bit twisted up, you know, so you got to just look around and there it is, find it. And we're going to yarn over twice and go around the post and do a front post triple around the second one that we skipped here. Just like that. Like that. And then what we're going to do is go directly into the next stitch, which is right over here. Not this one, because you could see it has a front post triple crochet around it. This one way over here, and double crochet into it. And then we're going to double crochet into the next. And that will end the repeat of the cable pattern. So that's the cross part of the cable. Sometimes you got to put your thumb in there too. There we go. Now we're going to do it again. Another cable. So remember, it's worked over four stitches. So we're going to yarn over twice because we're going to do a front post triple. We're going to skip the first two, skip, skip, and around the post of the next, we're going to work a front post triple crochet. Like that. And then the next one, a front post triple crochet. Like that. And now we have to do the cross part of the cable. This is where we back it up and we do the front post triple around the two stitches that we skipped, starting with the first one. So we're going to yarn over twice and go around the post of that first stitch that we skipped and do a front post triple. And then the next one that we skipped, remember, sometimes you have to dig around to find it. Front post triple around that one. Just like that. And that is the cross part of our second cable. Now we're going to go ahead and do a double crochet into the next two stitches, starting with this very first one way over here. Double crochet. And then a double crochet into the next. And then we repeat that again. So this cross part of the cable is probably the hardest part of the cable. It's just doing the crossover. And it's not really even hard once you get the hang of it. Trust me, you can do it. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and start again with the cable. It's worked over four stitches. So we're gonna do a skip two, skip, skip, and then the next front post triple. And then the next one, front post triple. And then we're gonna back it up and do a front post triple in the two that we skipped, starting with our first one, just like we did before. And then you find your next one who always hides. There he is. And front post triple around him. There you go. Now we're going to do a double crochet in each of the next two stitches, starting with this one way over here. The next one that's not worked, right here. Double crochet. And then double crochet in the next. And we're just going to repeat this pattern until we get to our stitch marker. So you can see how easy that is. So we got three cables made there. Well, partially made. So I'm going to continue this and I'll meet back up with you when we get to our stitch marker. All right, so I just did my last cable before where we put our stitch marker for the point. And you can see I have two stitches left and then the point that our marker is in, or the stitch that our marker is in. So I'm going to double crochet in those two stitches before our stitch marker. Now the stitch marker is going to be the point, front point of the poncho. So you can go ahead and take it out now. We're not going to use that anymore. And in this stitch, it's always going to be the same. We're going to work two double crochets into that stitch. There's one, and there's two, and then we're going to chain two and go back in and work two more double crochets. Now remember, that is will always be what your front point will get in the space here. You'll always get two doubles, chain two, two doubles. All right, so now what we have to do is make this side match this side. So we're just going to repeat what we did on this side over here by starting off by putting a double crochet into the first two stitches. There's one, there's two, and then we will start our cable. So we skip our first two, next two stitches, skip, skip, and front post triple around the next, and then front post triple around the next, and then we're going to back it up to the two that we skipped, starting with the first one, and front post triple into that one. And then front post triple into the next one that we skipped. Like that. There's our cable. And then we're going to put a double crochet into the next two stitches. So it's the same as we did on the other side. Just like that. And then we're going to do start our cable again. And then double crochet in the next two. Cable, double crochet in the next two. It's the exact same thing we did on this side, and I'll meet back up with you when we make it back here to our starting point. All right, so I'm coming to the end of row two, and I just did my last cable, and you can see that I have two stitches that remain. I'm going to do a double crochet in those remaining two stitches, and I'm going to show you how we're going to end each row every time. Now this is the back point of our shawl or poncho, I'm sorry. So as you can see, we started off with two double crochets into that very first stitch. Now we're going to end with two double crochets in that same stitch. So go back in and put two double crochets in that same stitch. So it matches the front point. Now instead of doing a chain two, we're going to do a half double crochet into the very first double crochet that we made. So yarn over and go into that very first double crochet and do a half double crochet. Now that half double is acting as a chain two space. Now this eliminates any slip stitching that we would need to do. So normally if you would end by slip stitching, you'd have slip stitch rows all the way, you know, they start going down your poncho. Doing it this way, you can always start in the back center point and there will be no seam of slip stitching. It's just going to be always starting here. Perfect place to start. So we're going to go ahead and start row three. Rows three, four, and five are the repeat rows. And we're going to start right here in the center. Remember, this half double that we did is acting as a chain two. So we're gonna chain one, which doesn't count as a stitch, and we're gonna go back in here and we're just gonna start with two double crochets into this spot. We will do the other two when we make it back around. So two double crochets, like that. And then we're going to put a double crochet in each stitch until we get to our cable. On that last round, row two, you should have had six cables on each side of your point, so a total of 12 cables. So we have to remember though to go into this very first stitch that we put our half double in, see that? And double crochet into that, because that still counts as a stitch. So go ahead and work a double crochet in each stitch until you get to your cable. All right, so now I'm at my cable. You can see right here where we did a bunch, we did our crossovers. Now we're not gonna work any crossovers now. We're gonna put a front post triple crochet into each of the next four front post triple crochets, starting with this very first one that is kind of set in the back. So we're gonna yarn over twice and front post triple crochet around that first one. And then we front post triple crochet around the second one, which is set in the back there, this one right here. So you can move your cables out of the way to find your stitches. And then we're going to do a front post triple around the two stitches that are in the front, starting with the first one. So there's no crossing this time. And then a front post triple around that last part of the cable, like that. There we go. So that's part of the cable we're still working on. There's one. Now we're gonna put a double crochet into the next two stitches, which were double crochets from the previous row. So there's one and two, and that is what we're gonna repeat for row three. So again, we're at our cable and we're going to put a front post triple into the first two stitches, which is actually the two front post triples that are set in the back of your work. So if you put your thumb in between like this, these would be the ones in the front and these would be the ones in the back. You always pull those to the side, the front ones, and you want a front post triple in the first one and then the next one. And then you can front post triple into the two in the front, starting with the first one, and then you go to the next one. And then front post triple into the last stitch of that cable. See how easy that is? Once you get that down, it's so easy. And then a double crochet into the next two stitches. And this is what we're going to repeat. I'll repeat it again. You're ready? We're at our cable. Remember, you put your thumb in there and you see there's two parts of the cable, two stitches in the front and two stitches kind of in the back. We go to the ones in the back first. So I always pull those front ones over just to kind of get them out of my way so I can see what I'm doing. And I'm going to front post triple into that first stitch of the cable. And then I'm going to front post triple into the next stitch that's set into the back, like that. And then I'm going to go ahead and work the two that are in the front, starting with the first one, front post triple. And then front post triple of the last stitch of the cable. Like that. There we go. And now double crochet in each of the next two stitches. Now we're just going to keep repeating this pattern until we make it to our last cable before the point. I'll meet back up with you here at our last cable before we get to the chain two space of the front of the poncho. All right, so I've done my last cable before my point, and I'm going to go ahead and put a double crochet in the remaining stitches until I get to my chain two space, which should be four here on this row. And then I'm at the front point of my poncho. So remember, we always do the same thing in the space. We're going to work two double crochets, one, two, a chain of two, and two more double crochets. Just like that. So now we just have to repeat over here what we did over here. So we're going to start off by putting a double crochet into every stitch until we get to our first cable, which should be four. And then we'll start again, the same as we did on the other side, with the cable. Put your thumb through there, and we work in the back two part stitches of the cable first, and we front post triple crochet around that first one. And front post triple crochet around the next one that's set in the back there. And then we work the two in the front. We front post triple crochet around the first one that is in the front. And then we front post triple crochet around the last cable, stitch of the cable. And double crochet into the next two stitches, which are double crochets from the previous row. So I'm just going to repeat on this side what we did on the other side until I get to my last cable down here, and that's where I'll meet back up with you. All right, I'm coming to the end of row three. I just did my last cable, and I have four stitches that remain. I'm going to go ahead and put a double crochet in the remaining four stitches. Now remember, we end the back point differently than we do the front point. So we started with two double crochets into the chain space. So we're going to go ahead and put two more double crochets now into that same chain space. So it matches the front. And then we're going to end by putting a half double crochet into the first double crochet, which is going to act as our chain two space. And that ends row three, and you'll still have six cables on each side, or a total of 12 altogether. So why don't we go ahead and start round four? So we're going to start right here in the middle here with a chain one, and we're only going to work two double crochets into this chain space at first. And now we're going to work one double crochet in every stitch until we get to our next cable. So it should be six. Remember to go into this very first one that we did put the half double in, because it still does count as a stitch. All right, and now I'm at my cable. So we're going to start the repeat of this round four. And we're going to put a front post triple in each of the next four stitches of the cable. So starting with the first one, the second one, the third one, and the fourth one, we're just going to put a front post triple into each of those. We're not going to do a crossover or anything on this row. So there's a front post triple in the first one. Front post triple into the next one, and then again into the next one, front post triple, front post triple into the last stitch of that cable. There we go. Now I'm going to put a double crochet into the next two stitches, which should be double crochets from the previous row. And that's the repeat now. I'm just going to repeat that again. Front post triple crochet in each of the next four stitches of the cable, starting with the very first one. And then front post triple into the next one. Front post triple into the next one. And front post triple into the last stitch of that cable. And one double crochet in each of the next two stitches. One. And there's two. So there you have your second cable done. I'm just going to repeat it again. Front post triple crochet into the next four stitches, which are the four stitches of our cable. And then one double crochet into the next two stitches. So I'm going to go ahead and repeat this pattern until I make it to my next chain two space up here, the front point of our poncho. All right, so I made it to my last cable before the front point of our poncho, and we should have six double crochets there before we get to our chain two space. We'll go ahead and double crochet in each of those. And then in the chain two space, we do the same thing that we always do in the front, which is two doubles, a chain of two, and two more double crochets, just like that. And now we're going to repeat on this side what we just did on this side. So we're going to do a double crochet into the first six stitches here on this side. And now we're at our cable, and we're going to do a front post triple crochet in the next four stitches, which is the four stitches of our cable. Like that, and then we're going to put a double crochet into the next two stitches. So we're just doing on this side what we did on the other side. Again, we're at our cable, so we're going to do a front post triple crochet into the next four stitches, which are the four stitches of our cable. Front post triple crochet. That and double crochet into the next two stitches. So I'm going to go ahead and repeat on this side what we just did on the opposite side over here until I make it to my last cable. All right, I'm coming to the end of round four, and I just finished out my last cable, and I have six stitches that remain. Go ahead and double crochet in those remaining six stitches. And now we have to end the same way we always end the back point. We started with two double crochets in that chain space, and now we're going to end by putting two double crochets into that chain space. And a half double crochet into our first double crochet, which acts as our chain two space. And that ends row four. And you still should have six cables on each side, or a total of 12 cables. Now row five is what we're getting ready to start, and row five is the final repeat row. Now this is where every time you repeat this row, you add, we're gonna be adding more cables. All right, so it gets larger now. It's been getting larger, but now it's gonna get larger with more cables. So it's very similar actually to row two that we did way down here, but let's go ahead and do it. So we're gonna start off with a chain one, and remember here in this first chain space, we just start with two double crochets into that space. So there's one and two. Now we're going to put a double crochet into the first two stitches, and remember we have to go into the one that we put our half double crochet in. That counts as one, and then a double crochet into the next, like that. And now we're going to start a new cable. Remember, the cable is worked over four stitches. All right, so we got four right here. This is the twist part of the cable again. So like I said, it's very similar to row two. So we're gonna do skip two, skip in front post triple crochet around the post of the next stitch. And then we're gonna front post triple crochet around the post of the next stitch. And then we need to back it up to the two that we skipped and front post triple crochet around the first one that we skipped. And then around the next one that we skipped. Just like that. And that's the twist part of our cable, and we have started a new cable. Now we're going to put a double crochet into the next two stitches, just like that, and that should bring us to our next cable right here. See that? So we've started a new cable, and now we're at our next cable, and we're going to do the twist again. We have to do the twist again. So we got the four stitches here of our cable, so we're going to skip the first two, skip, and we're going to front post triple around the post of the next one, and then a front post triple crochet around the post of the next stitch of the cable. All right, so now we're going to put a front post triple crochet around the post of the first stitch that we skipped, and a front post triple around the second stitch that we skipped. And that is our cross part of our cable. It does get a little twisty, so sometimes you gotta untwist it. And a double crochet into the next two stitches, just like that. And that's kind of what it starts to look like. So we got the crossover part again, and you started a new cable. So we're just gonna repeat this until we get to the last cable here of our row, or till we get to our chain two space, the last cable before our chain two space. But I'm going to go ahead and repeat it again. So here we are at our cable again. So we got to skip the first two stitches of the cable and front post triple crochet around the next stitch, and then front post triple crochet around the next stitch of the cable. And then we got to back it up and front post triple crochet around the two that we skipped, starting with the first one that we skipped. And then the next one that we skipped. And then again. And double crochet into the next two. And like I said, this is very similar to row two. but we're just going to keep repeating this crossover until, like I said, I'll meet back up with you at the last cable before our chain two space down here at the point. Alright, so I just finished my last cable, and here is the chain two space to the front point of the poncho. Now we have to add another cable down here. So, we're going to go ahead and put a double crochet into the next two stitches. There's one and two, like that. Now we're going to do a cable. Remember, it's worked over four stitches. And we're going to do it the same way. We're going to skip the first two, skip, skip, and work a front post double crochet around the next stitch. And a front post double crochet around the next stitch. And then we have to back it up to the two that we skipped and work a front post double crochet in those two, starting with the first one that we skipped. And then the next one that we skipped. And there we just added another cable here. And we have two stitches left before the chain two space. Go ahead and put a double crochet in those two stitches. And now we're at our chain two space of the front of our poncho into the chain two space. We always work the same. Two doubles. Chain two and two more double crochets into that spot. And now again, we are just going to repeat what we did on this side on the opposite side. So we have to add another cable here. So we're going to put a double crochet into the first two stitches. And we are going to skip the next two, skip, skip, and front post triple crochet around the next. And then front post triple crochet around the next. And then we back it up and front post triple crochet around the two we skipped, starting with our first one. There's one front post triple. And then the next one that we skipped, front post triple. And there we started another cable there. And now we're going to repeat. We're going to put a double crochet into the next two stitches, just like that. And now we're at our next cable. And this is where we have to do the crossovers again. So we just repeat. We skip the first two stitches of the cable, front post triple into the next. And then front post triple into the next. And then we back it up to the two that we skipped and we front post triple into the first one that we skipped. And then front post triple into the next one that we skipped. And it's okay if your cables look a little tangly. They'll start to look better the more rows that you do. And then we do a double crochet into the next two stitches. So we're just going to repeat what we did on the other side on this side, and I'll meet back up with you way down here at the last cable before we get to the back point of the poncho. All right, I've come to the end of row five, and I just finished out this last cable. Now we have to add another cable here at the end. So we're going to put a double crochet into the next two stitches. And then we're going to put a cable. It's worked over the next four. So we're going to skip two, skip, skip. And in the next, we front post triple crochet. And then front post triple into the next. And then we back it up to the two that we skipped, starting with the first one, front post triple, and then the next one that we skipped, front post triple. So there we have started another cable, and you should have two stitches left. Go ahead and double crochet in those remaining two stitches. And now we are at the chain two space, and we have to end it the way we always end the back point. We started with two double crochets. Now we need to end with two double crochets into that space. So there's one, and there's two, and half double crochet into our first double crochet, which counts as our chain two space. And that's it. Now you will have, you've added extra cables, so you should have eight on each side, or a total of 16, because you added four more cables, two on each side. Now you just repeat rows 3, 4, and 5 until you get the poncho as big as you want it to be. And every time you repeat the row 5, you will add 4 extra cables, 2 on each side. And you want to end on a row 3 or a row 4 repeat. Either one of those is fine. We just do not want to end on a twist repeat. So you just keep going until you get it as big as you want it to be. Remember, every time you repeat row 5 or the twist cable part, you'll add 4 more cables. 2 on this side, 1 more here and 1 more here, and then 2 on this side, 1 more here and 1 more here. And it'll just keep getting more cables the more times that you do those three row repeat. All right, so once you get your poncho as long as you want it to be, mine for the size I did 33 rows total. But you do it forever long that you want, to ever, however, you know, it fits you to the length that you want. You can end on any row, just do not end on a crossover row, end on one of the other rows. So you can see I ended on the row after a crossover row. And now I'm just going to go around the bottom with single crochet to kind of clean up the edges a little bit. Sometimes these cables kind of tend to flip up a bit, so I'm going to clean that up. So here's the, I'm at the back of my work. This is where I just tied off my last collar. I'm going to bring in some blue, but you use whatever color you want here, and go into this chain two space, and I'm going to chain one, and in this chain two space, I am going to work 3 single crochets. So there is 1, 2, and there's 3. Now I'm going to work around, try to hide my tails as I go, and work 1 single crochet in every stitch. So I'm not working any more cables or anything like that. It's just going to be single crochet around until I get to my next chain two space, or the front point of my poncho. So you can see I'm coming up to a cable, and I'm not going to do anything special. I'm just going to put 1 single into the top of every stitch. Just like that. And I'm going to continue this to my next chain two space, and that's where I'll meet back up with you at our front point of our poncho. All right, so I made it to the front of my poncho and the chain two space here. I'm going to work 4 single crochets here in this chain two space. So there's 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then I'm going to continue around putting 1 single crochet in every stitch along this other side. So we're just making this side over here look like this side over here. There we go. So I'm going to continue around working 1 single crochet in every stitch until I make it back to my starting point. All right, so I made it back to my starting point, and remember when we started, we put 3 single crochets into that chain two space. We're going to go ahead and put 1 more for a total of 4 That way it matches the front point. And then I'm going to end by slip stitching into my first single crochet. And then I'm going to tie this off and hide that tail. If you want to go around again, you could go around again. That's perfectly fine. I'm just going to do the one round here at the bottom though. All right, so now I'm going to go around the collar up here. And you use whatever color you'd like. I'm going to be using this blue. So here's the back of my work. As you can see, here's the tail where I started. And you just want to kind of go into any stitch here along the back side, in the middle of the back side. Pull your yarn through, and I'm just going to clean up this top edge with some single crochet. So go ahead and chain one, and then go back into that same stitch and single crochet. And now I'm going to work around, and I'm going to put one single crochet in every stitch around the collar of the poncho or the neckline, just to clean it up. So I'll continue around with one single crochet in every stitch, and when I make it back around to my starting point, I will meet back up with you. All right, so I've made it back around to my starting point here, and I'm going to end with a slip stitch into my first single crochet. And I think I'm going to go around again with one more row of single crochet. Now that is completely up to you. You can do one row, or you can do five rows, however many rows you want on the neck section. But I'm going to chain one, go back in that same stitch, and I'm going to do again one single crochet in every stitch all the way around. And then when I make it back to my starting point, I will end in a slip stitch into my first single crochet, and I think that'll be all I'll do. I'll hide a clip off my yarn and hide all my tails. But remember, you can do as many rounds here as you'd like. I'm just going to do the two. All right, once you got all your tails hidden, there it is. I think it looks really good. Turned out quite nice. So I hope that you enjoyed my tutorial and was able to follow along. Remember, if you make this or anything else from my tutorials, I'd love to see a picture. You could post a picture on my Bag A Day Crochet Facebook page or Instagram. There's links to both of those in the description box. Also, don't forget to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any of my other tutorials. And below in the description box, the very first link, it will take you to over 1,000 of my crochet tutorials. They're all free, you know, for you to enjoy. Do whatever you want to do with them. And if you enjoyed this, don't forget to hit that thumbs up. And I will see you on my next video. Bye, everybody.